Hi, I'm Chef Sally from the National Mango Board, and I'll be showing you how to make a creamy, luscious mango creme brulee, and we'll be finishing it off with a simple yet elegant mango rose. To begin, I'm going to put my cream, fresh mango puree, sugar into my saucepan. I'm going to place it on medium heat. So I'm using a vanilla bean pod. This brings an immense amount of aroma, beautiful, beautiful flavor that really complements fresh mango. I'm just going to cut it in half and scrape out the seeds. I'm going to add everything into my pot. We'll know this is ready to go once we see a little bit of steam coming up when it's up to scald. So you don't want to boil this too much because you don't want to have the risk of burning the cream. I'm going to remove the vanilla bean to slowly temper my hot mixture into my egg yolks so that I don't immediately cook the egg yolks. So this ensures a nice smooth consistency. So now I'm going to pour my mixture directly over the top of some diced mangoes I already have in my brulee dishes. Well, I added diced mango into the creme brulee just so that we have that contrast of fresh fruit and also puree in the custard mixture. Double the mango, yes. So if you don't have oval ramekins, you can use any other ramekin, maybe a round one or even a shallow bowl, just as long as it's oven safe and you can bake it in your oven. So first I'm going to put these in the oven and then I'll pour the hot water in the pan. If we don't add the hot water, you have a very high possibility that your custard will curdle and overbake. Now I'm going to make a simple but very elegant decoration that's going to go on top of our creme brulee. So I'm going to make a mango rose using a fairly ripe mango. When looking for a ripe mango, don't pay attention for the color. Give it a little squeeze and a ripe mango will give a little bit. So for this rose, I'm going to slice this half mango very, very thinly as you possibly can. So we'll start by making the center in which we'll just curl it up. And then from there, we're just gonna continue wrapping more slices around it. They do get a little slippery, so you can use a knife to help you pick up the pieces. So you get that little bend back there that makes it a little bit more realistic, gives it a little curve, a little life to it. And there you have it. Simple, elegant mango rose. So these I've made ahead of time and they've already chilled in the fridge for a couple hours. So now we're going to do the fun part and brulee the tops of these creme brulees, which ultimately brings our creme into the brulee mode. So we are going to top it off with some golden sugar. I'm putting enough sugar just to cover the tops fully, just to cover really all of that surface. So I'm using a regular kitchen torch just to burn the tops. So what we're looking for in torching the tops is we want that sugar to really burn. So without that caramelized sugar top, it's not a creme brulee. And now we're going to put our mango roses on top of our creme brulee. So I'm using an offset spatula to help me lift the roses and place them onto our torched creme brulee. So the best way to dive into your creme brulee is really by just, you gotta hit that top and you want that crack to happen. Just like that. Super yummy. Creamy, caramelly, mango-y. Those nice mango pieces are a nice contrast with the custard. Great ending for a meal. And the mango is actually extra cold. It's very nice on the palate. Thanks for tuning in. If you're looking for more mango how-tos, recipes, and information, visit mango.org to learn more.